Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor and pleasure to have the Prime Minister of Norway at the World Forum for Democracy, and I would like to commend her for the global role she has taken in that field, and also with regard to fulfilling the Sustainable Development Goals in the bilateral meeting right now. I explained a little bit about what the country of Europe is doing in this respect, and focusing afterwards mainly on what the Council of Europe is doing in order to get Turkey in line with its obligations under the European Convention on Human Rights and the case law in court here after the coup attempt. I know that Norway as a NATO member, in which Turkey is also, is very interesting in how things are developing in Turkey. And I would say that the European Convention and the Court of Human Rights here is now extremely important. One should know that also in a state of emergency situation, all the Turks have the right, still have the right to go to our court, and therefore we are discussing how Turkey shall now deal with all these issues under the case law of the court here, the European Convention, in order to avoid that thousands of applications are coming here. By the way, we have already got more than 20,000 complaints from Turks to the European Convention on Human Rights after the attempted coup, which of course is a telling story on how big the backlog of the workload of the court may be if the Turkish authorities are not dealing with all these issues in conformity with the European Convention and the Court of Human Rights. I think that this is nearly the only tool Europe has today to keep Turkey accountable and keep up its obligations under the Convention. But again, I'm very glad that the Prime Minister is here, and we really appreciate your time, in particular with regard to education, but also human rights and rule of law in general.
Thank you. Can I just start by saying I'm delighted to be in Strasbourg. I was 12 years ago speaking to the Parliamentarian Assembly at that time as a member of the government that then had the presidency of the European Council. It's always interesting to hear questions in the discussion and the focus that people have. But I also like to say that this is an opportunity also to help to follow up on a very fruitful meeting we had in Oslo earlier this year, in March, where we discussed a lot of those issues that are on the table in the European context, but on human rights and rule of law. As I said in my speech, I think there's an importance to the Council of Europe has a very important role to play in a world where some of the bases for democracy is more challenged, also in our part of the world, which we were hoping that had changed. The rule of law, the work against corruption, transparency, all of these issues, that is the basis for really feeling that people can feel that they are connected to a country and that they can feel that the democracy is functioning. And we see that there are challenges, and in Europe we do need to build more hope among young people, but also more connectedness between the politicians and the governments and the establishment and the whole part of the population. I think the SDGs is a very good platform to work on in these issues, so I was happy to be invited to speak at the World Forum for Democracy to talk about Sustainable Development Goals, but also especially about education. I think it's important to see the interlinkage between the different areas and the role that the Council of Europe really can have in this. Then, I, of course, I also believe it's that the reform agenda the Secretary General has put forward there, we are firm supporters of that. And I think there might be a renewal of the focus on the Council of Europe in these more difficult times. I'm also very happy that we have touched upon the situation in Turkey. I think it's there are several parts of Europe and member states in the Council of Europe now that are in having trouble on their democracy agenda. But Turkey, of course, is increasingly an area that we have to focus on finding ways to keep the democratic path, the rule of law, and as you said, it's Mr. Jagland, that it's also a NATO member. It's also Europe's way of gateway into the Middle East, so it's important how the development is functioning there. And I'm very happy that both the Secretary General and the whole Council of Europe have been taking active steps after the coup and try to help the Turkish authorities to deal with the situation post the coup in Turkey. I think it's a situation that we all have to continue to focus on, and as I said, there's more than enough trouble spots, but this is probably the most difficult one for the time being. But I'm also looking forward to discuss more during our lunch and on different topics. We still know that we have hotspots in the European context that we just a couple of years ago thought we had built a democracy that will function for the future. But I'm happy to be here. I think it's the Council of Europe will be an important institution in those more troubled times, and it's an important part of the whole SDG agenda. And I hope that we all can make all the different institutions around the world will adopt this agenda as their own in how to work, because I think we have built this roadmap for the future through the SDGs. 193 countries have signed on it, and we do have to push to make sure that they're also following up on it. And I think if you look at, as I said in my speech, SDG 16 and 17, it's very close to what the Council of Europe is really working on in our part of the world. So it's an agenda that should be very good to use for the Council of Europe in a meeting with different national authorities. Thank you.